Yo, what up, what up? It's Peter Rosenberg, Hot 97, ESPN, WWE, all that. Right now, you're checking out the Oddly Awesome Art and Culture Podcast. That's right, Oddly Awesome Art and Culture, all right? Well, my guy, Francis Ramos, okay? The Oddly Awesome Podcast, incredible. It covers street art, design, culture, so much more. So make sure you subscribe and check that out. What up, Francis? Hope you're good.
Like a lot of new writers around, like they, you know, you talk to them about a lot of old writers, so they don't even know what you're talking about.
Oddly Awesome.
We have a special graffiti squad.
Oddly Awesome to be here.
What'd you do last night? We did two whole cars. It was me, Dez, and me, P, right? And in the first car, in small letters, it said,
Oddly Awesome.
Greetings from the East Bay. I'm Francis, your host of the Oddly Awesome Art and Culture Podcast. Welcome to this oddly short.
Konnichiwa.
First things first, Happy New Year, Happy 2021.
21?
You made it alive, you survived that catastrophic calendar year that was 2020. Now onward and upward, right? Through all that, the last few months have been amazing for Oddly Awesome. First was the release of a couple of stickers, the classic logo design, designed by graphic designer Mike Nguyen, the script logo that you see all across social media in black and white. Second is the Uji Kaiju sticker, the sticker with the pink creature statue on it. Fun fact, that sticker is actually from a photograph I took of this creepy statue in Uji, Kyoto, while I was traveling in Japan with my friends in October of 2019. Uji's the location, home of green tea matcha. It's along a river. The Ujigawa River. Kaiju means monster or beast in Japanese. Think of Godzilla, Mothra, Hedorah, those kind of creatures. So, therefore, Uji Kaiju. Then was the release of the teaser trailer for this podcast. Many people didn't know I was going to do this and caught them by surprise. I'm glad it worked out, though. It came out really well. I'm pretty happy that it conveyed what I thought this podcast was going to be able to deliver. Then I was able to collaborate with my little cousin, Courtney Reyes, aka Ko-chan, and release a sticker that was dubbed the Bubble Design. A super fun typeface that's bubbly, had like highlights on it, super simple. We also released a 1:6 ratio hologram version of it, so little holographic sticker, so some of you had that randomly inserted when you guys signed up for stickers, so thank you and congratulations. After that was the release of my introduction episode. Many of you got to hear an abbreviated version of who I am, what my background is, where I went to school, and what my history in art is, so if you don't know or are interested about what I've done, go ahead and give that episode a listen. The biggest moment, I believe, and my proudest moment, is the release of episode 1, the Futura episode. So first, what I want to note is that what you saw on Instagram when that episode released was an idea that Mike Nguyen, graphic designer, and myself, what we came up with. We thought, what if we came up with a timeline that accompanied that episode, so something like optical that you can kind of swipe through while you're listening. I haven't really seen a podcast create a companion piece quite like this. I've heard of podcasts directing listeners to the like end of show notes or just a blog post of all the images that they referenced, but nothing quite like this with timestamps, and that's something visual that you can swipe, and quite frankly all original too, so pretty proud of that post in itself. In terms of the podcast, what I wanted to achieve was to try to keep it under 20 minutes, keep it super simple, and ensure accuracy, and I believe I achieved all of that, so it worked out. The episode got amazing feedback and amazing response, so thank you to all who downloaded it and gave the episode the time. That really means a lot to me. Surprisingly, the feedback I got was mostly from those who didn't know a single thing about Futura, those who had interest in street art and shared that, hey, you know what, I learned a lot in such a small amount of time, and I'm happy that you did. That was my goal, and I wanted to keep it simple, and it looked like it worked out, so thank you for those who gave me feedback. My biggest piece of validation, however, was receiving back and forth messages from Futura himself, so I still have to pinch myself about that. So his response, so just to share, his response in using the tag Futura 2000, then Futura, Futura himself said to me, quote, "Who would have known that Futura 2020 could have even been a thing on top of that? Exceeding expectations by such a number. So much for being prophetic. More a suspect of being ahead of one's time. Even the sequel of 2001 A Space Odyssey was only entitled 2010. We were all short-sighted." Wow. Wow. Like, for him to had spent time to listen to my show, my first episode, from this, essentially this guy in his bedroom recording all this, like, I was super proud of that. Pretty cool. Be sure to follow the Instagram at oddly.awesome. There you can find a link in the bio to sign up for some free Oddly Awesome stickers. We have a new design releasing in 2021, and they're always free. So follow oddly.awesome on Instagram. Before we cut to Rosenberg, I'd be remiss if I did not mention the passing of one of the most iconic rappers, the passing of the supervillain MF Doom. We found out on New Year's Eve through an Instagram post on Doom's account by Doom's widow that he passed on Halloween. Social media and the entire world was rocked by this news. To me, he's always going to be known as your favorite rapper's favorite rapper. Mad Villainy is probably one of my top 5 albums of all time. In my opinion, that has to be Doom and Madlib's magnum opus. I'll leave you with some words of wisdom by Doom himself. He says, "Shots of the scotch from out the square shot glasses, and he won't stop till he got the masses, and show 'em what they know now, the flows are like hot molasses." Rest in peace to the metal-faced one himself, MF Doom. Your legacy, your music, and your impact will live on forever. Thank you. And now, representing ESPN, WWE, and New York's Hot 97, throw up a two sweet for the mage one, Sweet Pete, Peter Rosenberg.
All right, let me give this a shot for you, Francis. As for me, you know, I'm no street art connoisseur or expert. I just have the things that I like and enjoy and have always enjoyed its connection to hip-hop. You know, being in New York, you sort of can't escape street art. And the way that it sort of meshes culture in New York, it's such an important piece of the aesthetic that is hip-hop, that is New York. So I'm trying to get my game up as we speak, actually, and learn from Laura Stiles and the cats who really know. You know, I grew up with a cat named Roger Gassman, who had a magazine called While You Were Sleeping that was a street art and culture magazine. So I always tried my best to learn. You know, I enjoyed the art of Cool Disco Dan when I was a kid in D.C. and always tried to appreciate it as best I could. But I leaned to cats like you, you know, to put us on to the real ish. The awesome art and culture podcast. What up?
What up? What up? What up? What up? What up? What up? Sayonara.